Hey Jude, don't make it bad. Take a sad song and make it better. Remember to let her into your heart. Then you can start to make it better.
Hey guys, Gregory here. Today we're going to be learning how to play Hey Jude by the Beatles. It's a fun, simple song to play. There are a couple chords besides your usual major and minor chords in there, but I'm going to be explaining them as we go along. This song should be fairly easy to play for any beginner. I am going to put a bit of emphasis on how we strum the song. It's going to be really just one strumming pattern throughout the entire song. So let's take a look at it part by part. We have about four different sections to look at. Let's talk about the strumming pattern of the song. I'm going to demonstrate it on a D major. If you're not sure what a D major is, it's the first finger on the second fret, third string, middle finger on the second fret, first string, and third finger on the third fret, second string. And you strum four strings, the fourth to the first, and the strumming pattern goes like this. One, two, three, four, one, two. So it's a fairly straightforward strum because we're strumming down four times. But what makes it interesting is that we're accenting the third strum, the third down. And what we're trying to really do is we want everything to sound soft, and the third down is just a little bit louder than the others. So it sounds like this once again. Down, 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 like that. Okay? What we don't really want to do is we don't want to strum everything at normal volume. And then the third strum is loud, because that kind of takes away from the gentleness of the song, which might sound like this. Right? It's kind of harsh when we play it that way. All right, so the other thing we want to do to kind of add to the softness of the rhythm is, for whatever chord we're playing, when we're doing the softer strums, like on beats 1, 2, and 4, we can also try to hit the bass strings of whatever chord we're playing. So on D major, the bass strings would be the lower strings. That would be maybe the fourth and the third, maybe the second. I know it's a small chord, but we're just trying to hit the bass side of the chord. So we have like this. And then when we get to the third beat, we could strum the entire chord. So we have this. We have a short, short, and a wide strum. Short, 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 wide, short, 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 wide, short. It's a lot easier on bigger chords like G. So we have short, short, wide, short, short, short. So those two things, strumming the bass and then the full chord, and then strumming soft and then a little bit louder, kind of really add to the dynamics of the strum. And that's really what makes it kind of interesting, rather than just strumming four downs like that, which really has no character. We're on to the verses now. Now all the verses in the song are pretty much the same. So let's go through the chords that we're going to find in the verses. So one of the first chords we find is D major. I'm going to explain it again. It is the first finger on the second fret, third string, middle finger on the second fret, third string, third finger on the third fret, second string, and we strum four strings. Then we have A major. That's the first finger on the second fret, fourth string, middle finger on the second fret, third string, and third finger on the second fret, second string, and we have, that's a five string chord. We have A7 that usually follows right after A. So with that, we can just take the middle finger off A to play A7. Or sometimes if I hit an A7 without coming from A, I might use my first and my middle finger instead. It's fine. Then we also have a D7 chord. D7 goes with the middle finger on the second fret, third string, third finger on the second fret, first string, and the first finger on the first fret, second string. And then the last chord that we find on the verse is a G major. That's the first finger on the second fret, fifth string, middle finger on the third fret, sixth string, and the third finger on the third fret, first string, and we strum all six strings for G major. So the verse now goes like this. Hey Jude, then to A. Make it bad. And A7. Sad song. Then D and D7. Remember, going to D now, and then to 7, start, and then back to D. So let's skip ahead to the chorus now. The chorus has just two new chords in it. There's an E minor, which is the first finger on the second fret, fifth string, and the middle finger on the second fret, fourth string, and that's a sixth string chord. And then we have a chord called G slash F sharp. I'm going to demonstrate it as if we were coming from G major. So you can put your hand on the G major. And to get to G over F sharp, we take the first and the middle finger off, and the first finger goes up to the 6th string on the 2nd fret, and we can allow the 1st finger to just bend to just naturally touch the 5th string because we don't really want to hear that one, and we just strum all the strings, and that's a G over F sharp. So let's do a little run through of the chorus now. It starts on a D7 and we'll go after 4. I'll try to call the chords mostly. So 1, 2, 3, D7
anytime,
and then go into G, G of F sharp, E minor,
da, da,
D, A7,
da, da, da,
and D,
da, da, da,
and onto D7,
da, da, da,
and then to G, and G of F sharp,
da,
E minor, and G, and D, A7, sorry, and then to D,
da, da, da,
we go to D7. And next was Hey Jude. Alright, we're on to the last part of the song now. So there's one new chord in here, it's a C major. Now there are two ways you can play the C major. I'll show you the regular way and then I'll show you an alternate C that we can use. So your regular C major is the 3rd finger on the 3rd fret 5th string, middle finger on the 2nd fret 4th string, 1st finger on the 1st fret 2nd string, and that's a 5 string chord, the 5th string to the 1st. Or we can use what you call a C add 9 chord, and that is the 1st finger on the 2nd fret 4th string, middle finger on the 3rd fret 5th string, 3rd finger on the 3rd fret 2nd string, and pinky finger on the 3rd fret 1st string. That's 4 fingers on one chord. But it's a very pretty sounding C major. C add 9 is the name of it. Okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play the end of the last verse going into the outro. I'm going to sing it as well. I'm going to screw up that singing part because it's a bit difficult for me to do. And then I'll just call out the chords as I play them. So starting from the end of this.
Then you begin to make it better, 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 better.
And the outro D. Okay guys, so that was the lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. It's a really fun song to sing and play. If you did enjoy the lesson, please like, share and subscribe. It will help me out a lot. But until next time, goodbye.